See the next, that is the point in vector analysis chapter, that is known as the surface integral. And volume मागच्या व्हिडिओ मध्ये आपण डिटेल मध्ये लाइन इंटीग्रल बघितलं आणि आता आपण बघणार आहे सरफेस इंटीग्रल म्हणजे काय आणि व्हॉल्यूम इंटीग्रल म्हणजे काय। त्या व्हिडिओ मध्ये आपण असंही पाहिलेलं होतं की लाइन इंटीग्रल असेल तर एकच इंटीग्रल आहे, सरफेस इंटीग्रल असेल तर दोन इंटीग्रेशन डबल इंटीग्रेशन आहे आणि व्हॉल्यूम इंटीग्रेशन असेल तर ट्रिपल इंटीग्रेशन। सो फर्स्ट वन वी आर गोइंग टू सी द फर्स्ट दैट इज नोन एज द बी पार्ट आई थिंक बिकॉज ए इज लाइन इंटीग्रल। सो दिस इज द सरफेस इंटीग्रल। नाउ यू आर गोइंग टू कंसीडर एनी वेक्टर फील्ड पी बार, बार मीन्स एनी वेक्टर फील्ड गिविंग द वैल्यू इज आई वी एस जे वी वाय प्लस के वी सेट। ती हल्ली आपल्याला माहिती दिस इज इक्वेशन नो, म्हणजे आपण सरफेस इंटीग्रल कन्सिडर करत असताना एक वेक्टर फील्ड कन्सिडर करतो। जी वेक्टर फील्ड काय आहे त्याची व्हॅल्यू आपण दिलेली आहे ऑलरेडी, आपण आपल्याला ही टर्मिनॉलॉजी माहिती आहे। आय बी एक्स इज द कंपोनंट ऑफ व्ही अलॉंग एक्स एक्सिस, जे बी वाय कंपोनंट ऑफ व्ही अलॉंग वाय एक्सिस अँड कंपोनंट ऑफ व्ही अलॉंग झेड एक्सिस। ओके, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू कन्सिडर एनी सरफेस, लेट्स से दिस इज अ सरफेस of certain area. Suppose the area of this surface is ds. Ds is a surface. And through the surface the vector field is diverging or vector field is coming out or coming going inside. आता मला सांगा की ज्यावेळी vector field diverging होईल त्यावेळी नॉर्मलच जाईल असं काय सांगताय? सो नाव वी कॅन ड्रॉ एनी वेक्टर विच इज पेंडिंग इन दिस डायरेक्शन। सो व्ही बार इज अ वेक्टर, दॅट मीन्स ऑल द लाईन्स ऑफ फोर्स आर टेंडिंग इन दिस इन्क्लाइंड टू दिस सरफेस। फॉर दॅट पर्पज वी आर गोइंग टू ड्रॉ वन नॉर्मल वेक्टर, वन नॉर्मल वेक्टर विच इज एन बार और एन कॅप is a normal unit vector which is normal to this surface, not this vector. Okay, now we are going to define the surface integral. So the surface integral is given by the value of double integration over surface area S. You may say ds or s. Then v bar dot n cap ds. See what is that thing? Surface area or surface integral is given by double integration over surface area s. You can read like this: over surface area s. V bar dot n cap ds. Okay, so this is ds is a this small surface area. Ds is a small surface area. This surface area may contains that is the three outer things also. If we suppose This is a Cartesian coordinate system. This is a Cartesian coordinate system. In bigger size, you may consider. This is x axis, this is y axis, this is z axis. Instead of irregular body, if we consider the regular body like this, regular body, in xy plane, in xy plane, and if this is dx is the one side length and dy is another side length. So area of this surface may be dx into dy. That means we may suppose that dxy. So you may write, this is maybe in surface area, that is the xy plane, this is supposed to be dxy or dsx, whatever it may be. In case of yz, you may suppose that dsy. In case of this surface in zx plane, yeah, plane one. So that means this is dsy or dsz. So that means ds is a surface area which can be, that is the taken over this plane, xy plane, over this plane, that means yz plane, or over this plane, that means zx plane. But general formula is, this is the general formula, that means you may heard this general formula and read this general formula many times, so that you can use this general formula in future. So surface integral over, that is the surface area ds is equal to, surface integral over surface area ds is equal to double integration over surface area s v bar, means v bar is a vector field, dot product of n cap, where n cap is a normal unit vector, into. Okay, I think you understand this one. Now we are going to move forward. We are going to move forward. That is next one. That is volume integral. That means C part is volume integral. For that, I can erase this one. So now we are going to consider the volume integration. So again, suppose this is a surface bounded by surface area ds. Surface area ds. And here this surface area is bounded by some other surfaces, that is called as the volume. dv is a volume. And the vector field which is moving in this direction, where n cap is again the normal vector. N cap is a normal vector. Then the volume integration is given by volume integral is equal to. So V bar we have considered already, that is V bar is equal to I V x plus Z V y plus K V z. And now we are going to see the definition of volume integral. That is, volume integral is triple integration over volume V. Triple integration over volume V is equal to V bar dot dV. V bar dot dV. So this is the volume integral over the surface bounded by some volume, that is dv. Can you understand? So this is the volume integral we can define. That is, the volume integral is equal to triple integration over volume v bar dot dv. So where dv is nothing but the volume. If it is irregular, that is, we may suppose dv, or if you suppose the cubic form, if you draw a cubic form like this, dx is suppose the length, dy suppose height, dz suppose breadth. Then dv can be written as dv is equal to dx into dy into dz. So this is the volume. Is it? So volume consists of the surface area where the vector fields are coming out or going inside. That means you can apply this in electrostatic by keeping one electric, that is the positive or negative charge. And you know the total normal electric induction in, that is, in induction comes out. That means magnetic field or electric field comes out whenever. Then we can measure the electric field. We can measure the intensity of electric field by using this volume. That is, the volume integral is equal to triple integration over volume V into, that is, V bar dot V. So this is all about the volume integral. So that means in this video what we have seen, see once again revise, we have already seen the line integral, it is given by value 12 by 10 over curved surface C V bar S sanga into dl bar, V bar dot dl bar. बरोबर त्यानंतर सरफेस इंटीग्रल काय दिलेलं होतं सरफेस इंटीग्रल दॅट मीन्स एका इंटिग्रेशनच्या ऐवजी किती घेतलं आपण डबल इंटिग्रेशन घेतलं एस सरफेस व्ही बार डॉट एन कॅप डीएस किंवा हे असंही लिहू शकतो आपण डबल इंटिग्रेशन ओव्हर व्ही सॉरी डबल इंटिग्रेशन ओव्हर सरफेस एरिया एस व्ही बार इन डॉट ds bar where n cap ds n कुठलाही हे काय आहे स्केलर आहे याला युनिट फॅक्टर मल्टिप्लाय केलं तर त्याची व्हॅल्यू बदलणार नाही पण दॅट कन्व्हर्टेड इन टू दि वेक्टर इज सो दिस इज v bar डॉट n cap ds सो n cap ds इज अ कॅन बी चेंज एज v डॉट ds bar सिमिलर दिस कॅन ऑल्सो बी रिटन एज फॉर अ क्लोज सर्फेस दिस इज क्लोज सर्फेस v bar dot dl bar. So this is line integral, this is surface integral, and what is volume integral? Volume integral is equal to, in line integral only one integration, in surface integral two integration, where volume integral has three integration over volume v is equal into v bar dot dv. Your dl bar. Is it? So this is overall about the line integral, surface integral and volume integral. You can convert line integral into volume integral or surface integral. You can convert line integral into volume integral. Volume integral can also be converted into, that is the volume integral, line integral tumhi karu shakta सरफेस इंटीग्रल मध्ये कन्वर्ट करू शकताय लाईन इंटीग्रल व्हॉल्यूम इंटीग्रल मध्ये कन्वर्ट करू शकताय तशाच पद्धतीनं सरफेस इंटीग्रल सुद्धा व्हॉल्यूम इंटीग्रल मध्ये कन्वर्ट करू शकताय व्हॉल्यूम इंटीग्रल सरफेस इंटीग्रल आणि लाईन इंटीग्रल मध्ये कन्वर्जन करू शकताय बाय युजिंग थ्री डिफरंट थेरम्स बट फॉर युअर सिलेबस देर इज वन थेरम दॅट इज द सरफेस इंटीग्रल कॅन बी कन्वर्टेड इन टू सॉरी व्हॉल्यूम इंटीग्रल कॅन बी कन्वर्टेड इन टू सरफेस इंटीग्रल दॅट इज the Gauss theorem. We are going to see the Gauss theorem in the mathematics, that means mathematical physics, that is in vector analysis, where the volume integral can be converted into surface integral. Okay, but that can go, that will be studied in the next video. Till then, next, goodbye. Thank you.